Chase Bastion for the Metal Gods Meltdown, and today I am joined by...
By Romeo from Schizophrenia. Hi, guys.
It's great to be chatting to you this evening. Chance of the Abyss has been out a short while. How pleased are you with the feedback so far from media and fans?
Actually, very surprised. We didn't really expect this. We just wanted to put something out, you know, because we really wanted to do this for a while already, actually. We actually wanted to put a cover on the full length, but it didn't really feel right, so we just decided to release something afterwards, you know, like this EP. But yeah, we're really, I mean, surprised by all the feedback we have. So it's pretty cool. It's been really fun.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean, I've been reading up on me. A lot of people are giving really positive reviews, so that's epic. I mean, how did the process work for choosing the tracks on the EP? Because, I mean, you've got a bit of punky, you got thrash, you've got a bit of everything, haven't you?
Yeah, for sure. We really took, like, you know, from songs from all our inspirations, basically. And it's really hard to choose songs, man, because we have a lot of favorites. So, But yeah, in the end, we managed to get a nice package together. So, and we're really pleased with it.
Awesome. When will an original Schizophrenia album be released? Is there something during the year?
Well, we're basically working on it really hard, but we can't really say too much about that stuff.
Right.
There's nothing really concrete yet, but we have a lot of stuff in the making, actually. So, yeah.
So can you tell us your plans festival-wise? I mean, I know you're already going out with Warbringer and Evil Invaders. That's going to be amazing. But what about other festivals and tour dates?
Oh, well, we're... let me see for the ones I can already say something about, you know, like I can already say we're playing Alcatraz this year. Which one can I already announce as well? I'm actually not sure which ones I can talk about, but yeah, we have quite some festivals coming up finally, you know, because last year was a bit, you know, like meh. So now they're finally starting to get us on the lineup, basically. So that's really exciting.
Are there hopes to get over to the UK as well?
Yeah. We did the UK. When was it again? We pretty recently played there. I can't remember. It's I think it's a couple months ago. But yeah, it would be cool going back to the UK, actually.
Awesome. So when you are out playing live, do you plan to have like live streams at some of your shows?
We didn't really talk about that stuff yet, but would be cool if we could do something like that, you know, like for people that can't make it, for instance, you know. Would it be cool?
Yeah, absolutely. So going back to the EP then, I mean, you've got Slayer on there, GBH. Have you got a load of others that you really wish you'd put on there?
Yeah, man, there's a ton of songs we could have put on there, but yeah, like we wanted to do some from like some more black metal as well, like Dissection, for instance. We love that band. But yeah, I mean, in the end, you have to make choices. So we just went for our punky side, like the heavy metal side, of course. And then, yeah, you know, like your thrash ones and the death metal one, Morbid Angel. But man, there are so many we could have picked. But yeah, it's just, you know, like, I think it's cool we chose Necrophiliac from Slayer instead of like songs from like the Rain and Blood era or something, you know.
Yeah,
I think like the ones from Hell Awaits, for instance, I think they're like a bit underappreciated in our opinion, so that's why we chose Necrophiliac. So
brilliant.
Yeah.
Brilliant. See, one of my favorite Slayer songs is a lot slower is Dead Skin Mask. That would be fantastic.
Yeah.
Or maybe some Carcass, a bit of Carcass in there as well, a bit of everything. Absolutely.
For sure.
Okay. Belgium has a really cool rock and metal scene. Why do you think that is? I mean, it's a small country, but it has a really good scene, especially with yourselves and Evil Invaders.
Yeah. Well, I don't know, actually. I think we have quite some... I mean, of course, like you said, it's like a really small country, so it's really easy to go from place to place and like meet other people that are in the scene, basically, and like organize shows. It's mm-hmm. a lot more easy, you know, so I think it's easier to connect that way. Maybe that's, you know, also we have, you know, because of the festivals. But yeah, I don't know. It's a good question. I'm not really sure. I think, you know, it's just easy to connect with people and like, you know, organize something, for instance, you know, because it's such a small country. So yeah.
Yeah. Can you tell me then what was the first concert you ever went to, and be truthful?
My first concert was a Cannibal Corpse one.
Cool. Really? That's impressive. Yeah,
it was Cannibal Corpse, and I'm trying to remember when exactly it was. Can't really remember properly, but it was a Cannibal Corpse one. It was, I think it was maybe somewhere 2011 something ish. I think it was that 11 or 12 maybe. But yeah, that was my first one. That was my first one. Yeah,
cool.
That was pretty awesome. Yeah.
Okay, yeah. I want to go back to the EP again with the album, with the EP cover. That's a really cool sort of nearly Sepultura-ish. Do you plan to have that tattoo?
Yeah, we've actually. Well, for me at least, we've been thinking. Well, I've been thinking about it a lot to get that like tattooed. Yeah. You know, but with the boys as well. You know, like so. Yeah, I mean, we like the logo a lot, and it's really so. I think it's time for us to get one, you know, all together. It would be really awesome, actually. So
if there was a thrash metal song about yourself, what would it be called?
Holy shit. Oh man. Thrash metal song about me. Probably it's gonna be something to do with fries and stuff. Oh man, I don't know. But yeah, for sure something with fries. I god damn it, I don't know.
Well, Belgium staple diet, fries and mayonnaise and beer. Yeah. Love it.
Yeah, something like that.
Yeah. All right, next one then. Can you give me 4 words to describe schizophrenia?
Well, for sure heavy, but I would also say melodic, so that's the second one. Still no, I'm already using more words. I would say I'm not sure. I mean, that's my own opinion, of course. But refreshing, maybe. What would I take the fourth one? I don't know. The fourth one. I don't know. I really don't know about the fourth one. Thing is, it's hard to be like original, you mm-hmm. know, in because you have so many things that are already done in these kind of genres. So we're trying a bit to, you know, not really break out of it, but just like take more stuff as like influences. So so it's a bit more like, you know, approaching the old school stuff, but like in like kind of a refreshing way, I would say. Yeah, yeah, for that fourth word, man, I don't know.
No worries.
So, yeah.
Okay, so how stoked are you though about going out on the road with Warbringer? I mean, they're fantastic. Oh, man. Band.
Yeah, for sure, man. We're super stoked because our the previous tours they just kept like canceling and stuff, so it's really awesome to be finally, you know, to finally say that we're actually gonna go on the road, and like really, that's really happening, you know. We really can't wait to finally be on the road and like finally like play more of our new stuff, songs, you know.
Yeah,
to really present this album, because in the end we haven't really been able to present it properly, you know. So it's really nice to give people the chance to see, you know, us like showing the new stuff and really going out like all guns blazing, basically. So, and it's awesome, like, of course, you know, going with Evil Invaders and then Warbringer, you know, like also bringing this other band, Mason. So it's gonna be cool meeting those guys as well. So yeah, man, we can't wait. Really
brilliant.
Yeah,
okay, so it's now five questions, either or either. So the first one is festival or small intimate gig?
I would say small intimate gig, although small intimate gig for sure.
Cool.
Like to play yourself, or
yeah,
or like just
yeah,
to
which
go
do you
to?
Prefer which do you prefer yeah to play yourself or yeah to attend
yeah
which do you prefer? Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I like smaller ones. I mean, the bigger ones are awesome as well, but it's just harder to, I like to get like intimate bit with the crowd. So yeah,
brilliant. Next one is beer or waffles?
Beer. Nice one.
110 times. Vinyl or digital?
Vinyl for sure. Actually, vinyl. Digital is easier, but I don't know, there's something, you know, about the vinyl, like everyone else, you know, everyone else already said it, like, you know, like you have the cover art, and you know, it's like this small ritual you do, you know, and then you can like, I don't know, it's something about it.
Cool.
I like more, so I would say vinyl. Yeah.
Cool. Are you a saint or a sinner?
Sinner for sure.
Brilliant. And the final one is Kill 'Em All or Rain in Blood?
Oh shit, man. Oh man, that's a hard question, dude. God damn it. Man, like I can't choose, but I'm gonna go with Rain and Blood.
Brilliant. Okay.
Just because of like the evilness, you know, like.
Yeah, absolutely, man. All right, well, I want to thank you so much for your time for this interview. Do you have any final words for your fans, our viewers and listeners?
All right, well, just keep an eye on our socials. We're, you know, releasing stuff pretty much every week, you know, updates, and especially now we're gonna announce shit ton of shows. There's gonna be a couple of cool ones in there as well, and yeah, just check out the socials. Life.
of suffering starts on the inside. You president, my death the curious, you can only die once. Thoughts of being raped by the maid. Nothing is done, endlessly. be wrong. I use the wisdom to get through.